Kariba, a water wilderness at the heart of Southern Africa, Zimbabwe's inland Mediterranean, with a taste of raw Africa and an infrastructure geared for tourism. From lakeside lodges to lake cruises, there are few places on the African continent more spectacular. Lake Kariba was built between 1955 and 1959. The wall is located 620 kilometers below Victoria Falls at a mystical place known to the Batonga people as Kariwa. Standing 128 meters high and 633 meters long, it was the world's biggest man-made dam at the time. Costing the equivalent of $4 billion, it took 10,000 men, 1 million tons of rock, and 975,000 cubic meters of cement to complete. The Batonga said that their river god, known as Nyaminyami, would not allow the damming of the Zambezi. In 1958, floods known as the 100-year flood threatened the incomplete dam. In spite of considerable damage, the work was completed ahead of schedule and began generating power for the region in 1960. As the waters rose to cover just over 5,000 square kilometers of the Zambezi Basin, a rescue mission to save stranded wildlife began. Known as Operation Noah, it was undertaken by Rupert Fothergill, a legendary parks warden at the time. Between 1960 and 1962, some 5,000 animals, from snakes to monkeys, and even elephant and rhino were rescued. Moved to higher ground, mostly within Matusalona National Park, their descendants roam the lakeshore to this day. Once complete, the lake would change the face of Southern Africa forever. Launched in early 2018, Lake Kariba's newest luxury cruiser took to the waters. The African Dream has set the standard for safari cruising and caters to a discerning international clientele. But like any great creation, her final beauty would start with an idea and a meeting of minds. Months of planning saw the main bulkheads and then the greater skeleton, with finally the outer skin and interior walls being installed. Slowly, she took shape as tradesmen and designers scurried over her every inch like ants might build a nest. Construction on the 109-foot hull began at the GDI shipyard in Harare in late 2016. Scheduled to take a year to complete, the African Dream was finished ahead of schedule and left Harare late in 2017. Weighing a staggering 103 tons, she was loaded onto a multi-axle trailer, which in itself tipped the scales at 100 tons and began her marathon road trip to Kariba. The nearly 400 kilometer road trip from Harare would require an entourage of technical staff, escorts, and time. Wider than most roads in Zimbabwe, a rolling roadblock moved ahead of the African Dream, with her crew halting traffic, dropping power lines, and other utilities as she went along. With her top deck removed to enable her passage beneath such, the going was low, often taking a whole day to travel just a few kilometers. It was decided that no trees were to be felled along the way, necessitating careful trimming of branches and bush so as not to damage the hull. With segments of the trailer independently steerable, the expert crew negotiated some of the most difficult and treacherous terrain Africa has to offer. Not least of all, 77 kilometers of twisting Zambezi escarpment. Its narrow road and steep cliff edges, a nearly 3,000 feet drop from Zimbabwe's plateau to the hot lowlands of the Zambezi Valley below. During the entire three-week journey to Kariba, the crews concluded their days on the roadside, sleeping beneath the African stars. Once at Kariba, a suitable point was chosen of which to launch the African dream. Her top deck was refitted, air conditioning installed, as well as generators and a host of other equipment. This and the launching process took 10 days, while crews fought the elements and other challenges presented to them. 200 tons of ship sitting on the relatively soft lakeside inevitably sank into the soft sand as the riggers fought frantically against the clock, using powerful rams to push the boat off the trailer, inching her ever closer to the water. Giant tubes and rollers were placed beneath her. In the final stages, tugboats pulled her gently into the waiting waters of Kariba. From her launch, she was taken to and moored at the GDI harbor, where the final fitting and completion were undertaken before her christening ceremony. Vehicle after vehicle load of furniture, decor, and soft furnishings trickled their way on board. An army of cleaners and technicians swarmed every inch of her 109 feet length. In just days, she was ready and repositioned at a popular harbor in Kariba, ready to welcome her first guests. As the band played in the muggy heat of Marineland Harbor, guests enjoyed welcoming cocktails, delicious snacks of Kariba bream and crocodile tail, after which the gathering was addressed by owners and staff.
J'espère que tout va bien, que vous avez passé un agréable vol. J'imagine que c'était un petit peu agité. En tout cas, on est très heureux de vous accueillir aujourd'hui. C'est maintenant est venu le moment.
Ah, mesdames et messieurs, quel honneur de vous recevoir. Et puis vous avez...
And a blessing said over her future voyages. Just before boarding, as is customary for a new vessel, a bottle of champagne was broken over her bows and guests hustled on board for an early evening departure. Nosing her way out onto Kariba, she set sail for an overnight stop on a nearby island. Typically, the African dream embarks on a three-day voyage through the eastern basin of Kariba, up the majestic Sanyati River with its towering gorges, along the Matusalona National Park, where wildlife abounds, and back to harbor after overnighting at Antelope Island. During the cruise, guests are treated to game viewing from African Dream's mini cruiser, or are whisked away on safari vehicles for a morning drive into the national park. Game abounds. Kariba truly is a living Eden, boasting incredible wildlife and bird life. After the three-day Kariba cruise, guests embark on the remaining 3 days of the six-day safari. A visit to Victoria Falls.
Oh,
then onto the Chobe River in Botswana, a part of the continent which has been hailed as the Galapagos of Africa, where they are hosted at Cascades Island Lodge. The African dream is indeed a marvel of shared passions, French engineering, and African ingenuity.